Okay, with me in the studio is Dibang, senior journalist, senior television journalist and analyst. Also with us is Sanjeev Kumar, member of parliament of the Jharkhand Mukti Morcha, JMM. Thank you very much. He's in the Rajya Sabha. Joining us from Jamshedpur, Sariyu Rai, former BJP MLA. He knows a lot about this story. Former CBI director Joginder Singh is also joining the panel this evening. We are also joined by Anupam Gupta. He's been the lawyer in the Ashok Khemka case. He knows what it is to be on the other side of the law, try and push the system. So I'd like to thank you all for joining me. Also joining us is Rajiv Kumar, counsel for the petitioner Durga Rao in this case. Thank you very much. Kretiya Tulsi, senior advocate, also joining us on the debate. You know, Dibang, the question is this: had it not been for, for the media pushing this case, nobody would have cared. This man would have lived the life of a media don, and it was almost as if this scam itself had been, you know, the files had been closed and tucked away in some cupboard in the enforcement directorate.
Congratulations to you, Arnav, for that, because, you know, you need that kind of doggedness. You have to be after a case, you have to believe in your information, you have to try again, because this is the work the investigating agencies with all kinds of facilities should be doing. But they don't do this kind of cases. We have seen repeatedly. Arnav, you would remember Kotroki, all the mafia dons have been interviewed by the media.
Somehow
the official agencies fail to do their work. Why is it so? I think they are vested interests. I mean, we know this character who's coming, and we know Congress, they've been disproportionate assets cases against Congress leaders after Madhu Kora's arrest. So we know more worms will come out. So they want to keep the lid on it. They don't want to open the box. But I think what's happening now, and that's very important, maybe we'll talk about it later, how the media is playing a role and how it's no longer possible. It's no longer the days of Narasimha Rao when, you know, he would say, so what? As something comes out in the media, so what? It will be there for a week, two, three days, and then it will die down. People will forget, move to the next story. But that's changing now.
I hope it emboldened the system. But Joginder Singh, isn't it shocking? The agencies do absolutely nothing. It seems the media has taken over the role of the investigating agencies in our country.
First of all, I would like to congratulate you for tracing this man. But let me tell you, neither the Enforcement Directorate nor CBI has jurisdiction on other countries. There are extradition treaties which are laid down. There are methods of investigation. You have to send a letter rogatory to those countries. They question them. They may not take interest here. We have no jurisdiction, neither you have jurisdiction. But you, as media, have advantage. You can go and talk to anybody, though you can't arrest anybody. Neither can we do it also. All you mentioned about Kutruchi. Yes, we tried our best here.
Sir, what is this? Sir, enforcement directorate.
You would notice,
sir, 1 minute. Sir, enforcement directorate.
Minister sent
sir, one minute. Sir, enforcement directorate can't go to Indonesia.
Saying there is no case against
this man. This man, Joginder Singh Ji. Joginder Singh Ji. He actually is wanted by the enforcement directorate. And let me tell you, he goes coolly to the Indian embassy.
No, true.
And gets his passport renewed.
Even then, this
so on the one side, we are told in
no
India this
power
man is
to
missing.
Question him.
The man goes, and I'm told he's been treated like a VIP in the Indian embassy out there. He goes and gets his passport renewed. What kind of a sham is this?
That is something for external affairs to take notice of it here. But so far as the legal procedure is concerned, no government agency either in Indonesia or in India can bypass the laws. Can bypass the Interpol rules or extradition treaties here. Of course, it's open to any government, which very few government do.
Let's be very direct. Joginder Singh Ji, our debate is warming up. Let's get everyone into the debate. Tell me, Sanjeev Kumar, what is the real story here? How is it possible that such a massive scam is perpetuated between 2005 and 2008?
Yes.
And between 2009, when the Koda diaries come out, and 2012, it appears as if the story has just vanished. 4,000 crores just vanished.
Yes. Actually, Mr. Madhu Kora and other co-accused persons must be in the police custody or custody of the prosecution. And in course of investigation, he might have revealed their names and other contacts.
Whose names?
This Bastawa Mbade and other people who were involved.
Yes.
And it was incumbent and it was duty of the prosecuting agency to keep track on him. And the man just walks in the embassy and gets his passport.
So how does that happen?
Yes. So this is the 100% negligence on the part of investigating agent.
Only negligence?
Only
negligence or connivance?
No, but they may not have been informed.
To some extent, we can say that possibly.
How is a kingpin treated like a VIP? Enforcement director puts an affidavit in the Supreme Court.
So enforcement.
It says, in the affidavit, it says it is very strange that very important documents get misplaced or lost at the hands of embassy officials while diplomatic channels are considered the safest. This, coupled with the fact that no efforts were made to retrieve them, is indicative of the influence likely to have been wielded. Mr. X or Miss X was putting influence to save Anil Adinath Bastawade. Do you think so?
Yeah, Arnob, actually you will have to understand the things first. It was first of all investigated by CBI. CBI investigated the matter, and the subsequently enforcement directorate came into picture.
Sir, are more powerful politicians involved in that?
We can say so.
And do you have any doubt about it?
No, actually, unless we have concrete evidence, so with certainty we can't say. But someone very powerful must be behind all these things.
Precisely. I'm not getting into Sariu Rai. I know you have a lot of information. I like to say that I'm not getting into naming individuals, because unless we have legal proof that XYZ individual is involved, I don't want to get into naming individuals. But the bigger story is that when Madhu Koda was a chief minister, income tax officials wanted to raid him. They were not allowed to raid him. Am I correct, Sariu Rai? Am I correct?
Yes, you are right. You are correct. You are 100% correct. You are correct.
So, jab baadi khet ko khane lag gaya, what is left?
So influence was being used to protect Madhu Koda?
Yes, very much. Entire government of the Jharkhand and the supporters of the governments at center, they tried to influence the investigation, and they also tried to hush up the matter. And scam was going before their naked eyes. And in fact, they were not in favor to hand over this case to CBI. In 3 months' rule, Sibu Soren as a chief minister, four times the government appeared before the High Court with an affidavit that this case should not be investigated by the CBI. We are competent to deal with it according to our own rules and with our own vigilance. So it is the mercy of the court or decision of the court due to which the case went to CBI. So entire government from 2007 to 2011 were supporting the scamsters, and they're trying to protect them.
Yeah, and now I will hold up
excellent
parts of what I have, which are the infamous Madhu Koda diaries. Now I'm not saying this politician or that politician, but suffice to say, and without my taking names, let me say this: names of very important politicians are in these papers. Now you can argue that this is not legally valid enough evidence, but names of very important politicians are in these papers.
I'm only putting a question up today.
Why should two and two not be linked? That politicians trying to save themselves were very happy with keeping the scheme in Indonesia. Let him be as far away from us as possible. KTS Tulsi, classic case of
deception. Yes, right.
Classic case of attempting to conceal the truth.
Yes, of course. Even
any attempts at obfuscation of the truth, those people. I would say that anyone involved in screening an offender, anyone screening the offender would himself be liable to be prosecuted for destruction of evidence. This is also an offence. To try to destroy evidence or try to mislead the investigation are also serious attempts at tampering with the endeavor to discover the truth for the purpose of bringing people to justice.
So, one is very surprised. So what were the agencies
that
doing till now? So why were the agencies sleeping? Why were the agencies sleeping till now?
They are part of the government. They don't have a constitutional status High Courts.
Sir, please,
It's quite surprising that the media house should be able to locate the person and the intelligence agencies can't. After all, if the United States could could locate even Osama right under the nose of the Pakistan Army, I wonder why our intelligence agencies couldn't locate this gentleman.
That's the biggest one.
Let the government tell them clearly, do this thing and they'll deliver the results.
Arnab, it's very simple. Joginder Singh ji, let me address this point to you. You were protesting. Aap ye keh rahe the. I'm saying this. It's very simple. You are playing on behalf of the government. Let's look at Uttar Pradesh, Arnab. There are two chief ministers, Mulayam Singh Yadav, this proportionate assets case. The court say, tell Supreme Court, don't be a handmaiden of the government. Just before the confidence motion, 2008, July 22, the court says, okay, CBI says, okay, we will pursue the case. Mulayam Singh saves the government, Arnab, and then it's decided later in that year, they decide to withdraw the case.
Precise.
Six times the CBI flip-flopped in that case in the Supreme Court. Okay, let's see the other party, NDA Alliance. Mayawati, December 2012, says in the Rajya Sabha that 2004, the BJP wanted an alliance in the elections. She said no. They said, okay, we'll start the disproportionate case, and the case is started. So CBI works on behalf of the government. You're not interested. You know that more people will come out, more names will come out. Government is not interested. That's why you're not interested.
This is simple.
You don't want to do it.
CBI supposed to do its job or keep its political masters happy? Joginder Singh, let me remind you. What happened in the 2G case? What happened in the 2G case? The Supreme Court had to really pull up the CBI for its slipshod investigations, saying the same minister is continuing even today. No, so only when the court acts or the media exposes the agencies to their job. Till then, agencies are the handmaiden of politicians.
The government wouldn't give permission for that. No, but this is how it is made. Right, same. From the British time, the same police system has been continuing.
The system does not serve the interests of the people. Is there an argument? This is how the system is made. Joginder Singh says this is the way the system is made.
Joginder Singh, that means what? That means you're not fair. You will do what the government wants to do. Whenever the government is in trouble, you will rescue them. You will file cases against people who are not amenable to the government.
Change it.
Is this why you're made? Is this what you're supposed to do as an investigating agency? That's the big question.
This is a very convenient...
It is not convenient. It is a fact of law. We have to go by what the law government makes.
Give me a plausible answer on this. You know what happened in November 2008.
About the rape laws by Arnab Goswami in the previous program.
I want to get in Anupam Gupta here. He's fought. He's been Ashok Kemka's lawyer in another case. He has strong views on it. Anupam, where do you stand on this? Joginder Singh says this is the way the system is. So should we leave it to the Supreme Court of India and to news channels to carry out investigations and have them followed up?
I must confess I am deeply dismayed and distressed by Mr. Joginder Singh's response, despite the valor which he showed in the Bofors case. Questions of jurisdiction come in later. Firstly, it's a question of will. Political will, the will of law enforcement. And may I point out, the Indian staff in the Indonesian embassy, the Indian embassy staff in Jakarta do not enjoy any diplomatic immunity or any other illegal immunity from prosecution. Their conduct appears prima facie to be most culpable. I think they should all, the concerned staff should be recalled, a proper inquiry or investigation conducted. And if they are guilty of destroying evidence, as Mr. K.T.A. Silsi rightly pointed out, they can be prosecuted as well or other action taken. Jurisdictional questions come in much later. This is a very serious issue, and anything short of the most serious and sincere and swift investigation will amount to a travesty of justice, a complete miscarriage of justice.
No, this jurisdictional issue also is a bit of a sham, isn't it? KTS Tulsi, you have represented the CBI in several cases. It's very convenient. CBI, ED, MEA don't work together. There's a little bit of confusion among them. Let me present a simple case to you. Here is a person who knows where 4,000 crore rupees went. He is the principal kingpin. He knows the hawala routes. He has a passport number issued by the Indian government. Yes. He goes and gets a passport renewed every 2 years. Nobody questions the passport. He keeps getting it renewed. He enjoys the life. Today, by this argument, KTS Tulsi, you know, even Dawood Ibrahim can hold an Indian passport, go and get it renewed every 2 years in a consulate, and then we'll say we had jurisdictional issues between the Enforcement Directorate and the MEA. We didn't talk to each other well. I mean, this has really become a sham, Mr. Tulsi.
This is bizarre. This is just not how the government can be run or justice dispensed. And investigating agencies have to know they are servants of law. They are not servants of politicians. They are not, and if they don't uphold the law, they are themselves liable to be prosecuted. And none of them should enjoy any immunity. And the government should not be able to save them by withholding sanction to prosecute. If these are the, this is the manner in which investigations are done, only for the purpose of frustrating justice and truth and bringing people who are accused of such heinous crimes to justice, then these are the persons who must be prosecuted, so that no one else can take this kind of
sham, Mr. Tulsi.
And no one else
can dare to do this. Mr. Tulsi, Hasan Ali, case was registered against him in 2007. When did debunk? Only in 2011, they started following up on the case. The Supreme Court had to pull up the Enforcement Directorate in that case also. So what was the ED doing in that case? Hasan Ali, Abdul Karim Telgi, I can give a thousand examples which were pushed by the media.
No, I'm absolutely shocked by the kind of reaction of the former CBI director. How can he say that this is how the system is made? So is he saying that there's no way out? I'm telling you, the way out is the media, what you are doing.
I'm sorry, unless the law changes, there's no other way.
And the heat that you generate,
you have to go by the law.
Studios,
if the government
it goes to the streets.
Tell the 10 o'clock, it is the daytime, we have to go by the law.
It's creating a buzz, it's creating a noise. And the heat is to the extent that
all
that
investigators
when the
are independent.
For the Chintan Shiva in Jaipur, they say that we don't know how to handle social media. So they're worried about it. And this is the way to go. And it's surprising. I'm very surprised that CBI, this is an opportunity for CBI to come out.
Sanction.
Media is already there and strong.
What do you do?
You
go
also
and fight
come
with
out.
Them?
Investigate these cases, investigate them properly. You cannot say this is how the system is made. Mr. Singh, I think you should retract your statement say something else.
It does not. Sorry. The truth must be said here. Change the system. This is what you see. First of all, there is no confession before a police officer is admissible. And secondly, how many persons are willing to come?
Are you saying this is how the system is? You won't investigate the cases. You will only investigate the cases that your masters want. Is that what you are saying? Is this the way you will give justice? What are you saying?
We don't give justice. Justice is given by the court. We investigate the case and take the court. If the government were to sit on the sanctions for years together, what do you do? Now, for
Mr. Joginder Singh, you have been CBI director. I'm a common journalist. One minute. Sir, allow me, sir. Mr. Joginder Singh, allow me. You see, we are common journalists. You are the sophisticated detectives of this country. Warren Anderson, media can find, government can't find. Otavio Quattrocchi, our cameraman bumps into him having coffee at Buenos Aires Airport. Government of India does not know where he is. Kim Devi gives interviews here. We catch him in Amsterdam. He's telling his story. Government of India follows up only after the media comes in. Now Anil Arinath Bastawade, we catch him in Jakarta, Enforcement Directorate wakes up and now Enforcement Directorate and Foreign Ministry are fighting each
other.
True. I want to know where are the two other people in this case. There are two other people in this case as
The point is here.
Am I right?
No.
Am I right? There are two other important people who are missing. It's not the only kingpin. There are two others believed to have interest in Dubai. Can you tell us more about
it? Actually, first of all, now this man has been apprehended and has been brought to India.
By that time,
the disclosure statement of other accused persons must be with the Enforcement Directorate as well as with the CBI. In case this person is confronted with other accused persons, keeping in mind with their disclosure statement, then everything, even if it is delayed, everything will be crystal clear.
Everything will be, explain more.
Yeah, actually in course of a police custody or prosecution custody of the other accused persons in this case, they must have or might have disclosed against this man about the modus operandi, about other routes, everything.
Yeah, so how do I know?
The disclosure statement must be with the ED and the CBI.
No, how do I know that statement is not tampered with? My question to Rajiv Kumar is, he's the counsel for the petitioner Durga Oraon in this case.
Yes.
Mr. Rajiv Kumar, my concern is they get Anil Adinath Bastawade because they are very embarrassed with what is going on Times Now. They cannot be exposed like this anymore. So you get him here. But what happens after you get him, Mr. Rajiv Kumar? How do we know that this man does not enter into some kind of a equal of what the Americans would call a plea bargain? Informal plea bargain, that, you know, I'll say this, I won't say this, I'll name these people, I won't name these people.
See, when he is in trap now and he has been brought to India, I must say this at these days, that so many other persons against whom the ED court has issued warrant of arrest, including this Saubik Chattopadhyay, BK Singh, and other persons are also there. They have not been tracked down by agency. See, I am congratulating Times Now that they have detected Mr. Bastawade in Indonesia, and now he has come down to Ranchi. He is coming tomorrow at Ranchi. But at these days, I am totally frustrated by the argument which is advanced by Mr. Joginder Singh, because I am from Ranchi speaking. That the manner in which yesterday Honorable High Court has issued one order directing the CBI to investigate the anti-corruption wing of the Jharkhand government. And you may ask one question from Sanjeev Kumar MP from Jharkhand, that a person whose name is Mr. M.L. Pal, he was previously the PA to Sibu Soren, against whom there is 65 crore clinching evidence, but he has not, no FIR has been registered by the CBI. And this shows the discrimination on the part of ED and CBI, that they are deliberately protecting so many accused persons in this scam. And I must say that the manner in which the reaction of the Joginder Singh has come, that the will of the investigating agency is important. Not the law is important.
Can I answer
here
that?
The every law is available in the country.
I will say total strength of
your comment. Take back your comment. The status quoist approach will not work in India anymore.
It
no, Mr. Joginder Singh, aisa hi chalta hai attitude.
Which come to us.
Will not work.
No. No.
Will not work.
Here, government should.
That's what Dibang is telling you. This country has changed.
No, they will take it up. If High Court has ordered this they will definitely give them time here. It is not that they can defy the High Court or Supreme Court. Nobody can do
how
that.
How much?
Not Arnav, the agency here.
Arnav, may I interrupt?
They will take it. You wait.
I'm asking you today. Rajiv Kumar has a follow-up question for Rajiv Kumar ji. Before you come in, I know that a top investigating officer was shunted out for unearthing this Koda scam. I'm not taking names today. The move was challenged in the High Court. The transfer was cancelled. Who shunted him out? Why are powerful politicians trying to influence investigations? Yes, Rajiv Kumar, go ahead. Your second question to Joginder Singh.
See, my question before Joginder Singh is that Income Tax Department investigation wing has brought on record not less than 80 appraisal reports, but CBI people have not touched those documents till date. About 3 months back, it has been handed over to CBI only on the basis of the order passed by the Honorable High Court. And Honorable High Court in the 2009 itself order has clearly stated that whatever the evidence will be collected by the Income Tax Department will be handed over to CBI. And CBI people and ED people have not yet registered any case, and they are pursuing only two cases in the Koda scam. Whereas Honorable High Court has clearly categorically stated in the order when the matter was handed over to CBI that each action will be having a separate cause of action. Until date, only two cases which are pursued by the investigative agency. This is unfortunate that a premier agency, ED or Income Tax and CBI, they are virtually not seriously investigating this case.
And secondly, as I told you, there is a constraint of manpower. Total number of investigators, which includes the prosecutor, is about 1200 with 30% vacancies. Sir. You can investigate only about 1200 cases in a year, as per the norms approved by the government here. So unless you strengthen the
CBI, these are standard arguments.
No, government is willing to
do that. Can I tell you, Mr. Joginder Singh?
You depend upon amnesty, you depend on state government, you depend upon UPSC to select people on deputation.
Sir, I am constrained to say this.
There is no power of the director. CBI is a whipping boy.
Sir, I am constrained to say this.
In the olden times, when a prince went for a study, he took a
Mr. Joginder Singh, don't complain about manpower. Don't complain about manpower, Mr. Joginder Singh, because two journalists from Times Now took 3 days to find Anil Bastowade. I'm saying this on record today. Two journalists from Times Now took 3 days to find Anil Harinath Bastowade. What are you talking about, sir? Don't complain about manpower. The question is whether you have the will or the courage or the bureaucratic and investigating gumption and guts to go after these scamsters. Isn't that the point, Dibang, that we are pushing here? Is it a question of manpower?
Absolutely. It's not a question of manpower. And I think if that is the case, then and if you are saying... But I'm shocked, Arnab, that he is saying that this is how the thing is. That means... Then do we need the CBI? We should scrap it. They are only going to help the party in power.
In this case, the Enforcement Directorate as well, actually.
ED also. They don't talk to each other. They don't work. They just work for their masters. We don't need such investigating agencies. What good are they? Nothing. They're here just to help their political masters. And it's Joginder Singh, you are such a senior person. You have been the director of CBI. How can you say this?
Yes. No, but this is a fact also. That present director will not say. But the point is here, somebody must say the truth here. These are constraints here, which every director has been urging Mr. before
Joginder
the government
Singh,
here.
Joginder Singh, I'd request but you to understand
no,
the reality.
Nobody takes action.
Mr. Joginder Singh, here's
so what I'm saying has been said earlier, but since nobody listens, I must say it again.
And that's the point I want to come to, the larger point. In today's day and age, Anupam Gupta, I want to come to you, and to KTS Tulsi. Mr. Joginder Singh, allow me one minute. In today's day and age, to find Warren Anderson, Anil Bastowade, Ottavio Quattrocchi, or Kim Davey for an honest and independent media is not difficult. That's the point. So Anupam Gupta, the problem is that the investigating agencies still earlier would put out some story, you know, difficult, location not established, etc. Today the media goes and gets these people. They have to change their number.
I think very commendable.
The investigating agencies, Anupam Gupta, will have to change the number and the excuses they give to the people of this country for not following up. Don't you agree?
No excuse, Arnab. You need the permission of the government to step out of India.
You see, there is, Arnab, there is a concept in law, in the civil law of torts, known as res ipsa locuta. A Latin expression which means the thing speaks for itself. The accomplishment of the media, Times Now channel in this case and the other electronic media in other cases, speak for themselves. And I think the moment this happens, any case where the media conducts an investigation and by comparison the investigating agencies, whether the CBI or the Enforcement Directorate or the Income Tax Officialdom, do not discharge their responsibilities, are openly seen to have failed in their duty, I think it's a prima facie case for immediate taking over of immediate judicial monitoring. Now we learn that the High Court of Jharkhand is monitoring the case. Perhaps it's a case of a situation where the Supreme Court itself, which was hearing the bail application today and granted 2 months further remand to the Enforcement Directorate.
Supreme Court must monitor
Mr. Madhu Koda, I think.
Yeah.
In the Supreme Court must monitor this case with very great and palpable seriousness. There seems to be no other way out.
The Supreme Court has to monitor this case. I mean, there seems to be, KTS Tulsi, you'd agree, given the bungling, given the fact that we are talking about the biggest case of open political corruption before CWG, that there is a necessity for the Supreme Court to monitor a case like this, to ensure the agencies don't do a cover-up on behalf of political masters.
Right. It's such a sad commentary on our entire system that the premier investigating agency is said to be incapable of discovering the truth because it is under the thumb of the government. Now, how many cases will Supreme Court monitor? The Supreme Court is also saddled with the responsibility of adjudication and the pendency is increasing. They also have to pay attention to their primary task of adjudication. But this is really unfortunate that people, the law gives the investigator a complete freedom to form his judgment.
It does not. It doesn't.
It's a problem.
Okay, I'd like to say pictures are coming in right now from our live streaming satellite link from outside the international airport. Those are the pictures of Anil Harinath Bastawade coming out. He is facing Indian justice. This man, bespectacled, 49-year-old, coming out of the airline. This Air India plane on which he's coming, and Times Now was with him. Times Now is the crew which followed him up there. This man being brought back to justice. Tell me, Dibang, as you are seeing this happen today, what are the thoughts in your mind? Is it time we change this whole definition of a media trial?
Really a moment of glory for you, for Times Now, and Arnab yourself, to be after this guy, to get him here. And I must say this, that this he's not the first one, Arnab. The way you got after A. Raja, the way you got after Kalmadi, they went to jail. But the need is to keep an eye on these guys. These two, the other two, Raja and Kalmadi, they should be punished. They should be sent to jail. And this guy, you have to pursue this case, Arnab, because...
Well, it's also the responsibility of the entire media to pursue the case now.
Absolutely, absolutely. And hats off to you that you are doing it. And, you know, because you just heard the comment from the CBI director. They are not going to do anything. You have the media, you have the social media, and this is the way now. This is the way for the future.
And
anger will spill over in the streets, and that's when they will wake up. They're already worried about it.
Yeah,
they don't
are.
Know how to handle it. Yeah. But I think this is the way to go.
And that's the camera out there. You can actually see Anil Harinath Bastawade, his scam kingpin. He's putting his head down. He doesn't want to be photographed. He knows the camera is on him. But in this very moment, which is being broadcast here on Times Now, I think it's a moment of great empowerment for the people of this country, isn't it, Dibang? That somebody who almost escaped the system is being dragged back. He's put his head down. And ladies and gentlemen, wherever you're watching this today, see this, a scam kingpin trying to avoid the cameras. And as I always say, you can run, but you cannot hide, can you, Dibang?
Yeah. And also remember that this is primarily because of one channel. They got after this man and got him here.
But now what happens to him?
Arnab, if you had left him, they would have forgotten about it.
Absolutely.
They would have said that he's not there. They wouldn't have even responded. But now that he's here, he should be. Now you have to pursue the case, Arnab, because the real test begins now.
Yeah, absolutely, Dibang, because the case begins now. This man knows the Hawala routes. He knows the politicians. He knows who Madhu Koda was operating through. He knows the smaller and bigger officials. Now he knows the media of India is after him. And I want to say this for our viewers. This man who's now been walking into the Delhi International Airport was still recently leading a life of absolute luxury. He is 24/7 security. A reporter said he lives the life of an absolute mafia don, almost seems to own an island. Indonesian officials were scared of him. He had invested through others hundreds of crores of rupees in coal mines, and all of this was bribe money, Dibang. It was nothing but bribe money. He had only funneled it out. He's not the only perpetrator of the scam, but this man knows who the other scamsters are. So this is really now a chance for us to take the story forward, because like CWG, this is pre-CWG, Dibang. We need to go back to the old scams and open them up, teach a lesson for the future.
Exactly. And I think this is also the time now, Arnab, to keep a close watch in the courts. He doesn't become, he doesn't try something like a plea bargain.
Oh, yes.
Because that can also happen, because if he does a plea bargain, or if he becomes a witness, he might be saving a lot of people.
My question
is, he has to be there in the dock, yeah, and he has to answer all the questions.
He can't be allowed to become an approver and get away.
He can't be.
He can't be. What do you think?
Actually, now that he should be confronted with, he should be brought before other accused persons. They should be... their earlier statements made before the CBI and Enforcement Directorate.
Absolutely.
And the investigation should be guided according to the earlier statements. And other persons who are in the custody, he should be confronted with them.
Well, he can't. The chips are on our side. We can actually call the shots, right?
No. Actually, you can only pressurize the investigating agency to properly investigate the matter so that unvarnished truth should come before the general public.
That's absolutely rightly said. As you say, the unvarnished truth must come out before the people. I want to ask Rajiv Kumar and Sarayu Rai, what are the tricks this man can try? And now he knows he's been captured. He knows the media of India has got him. He knows that attention will be on him. He can't just get away. What are the tricks he may try? Rajiv Kumar and Sarayu Rai, either of you or both of you can tell us. He's likely to try in the next few days to get away.
Mr. Goswami, I would like to throw light on another aspect of this scam. See, Manoj Punamia was already arrested. due to the efforts of the Times Now, this Bastawde is now also in the net. And we all, everybody called it a bribe money, and 4,000 crores, they have just laundered this money. And they have managed its investment all over the world in overseas companies. But from where this bribe has come? Who are the person who has bribed? Who has given the money? Nobody has pointed any finger. Only the income tax authorities had named a few big corporate houses. Problem is that they will be punished, but the source of money is still to be investigated. In such a huge amount, a huge quantity, black money is lying everywhere in this country. Corporate houses can bribe ministers and others, and people like Punamia and Bastawde, they may live a life of aiso aram, the luxury life they are living. But this money, where was this money lying earlier? This 4,000 crore which we are talking about was lying where, and from where he has come to Koda and his cohort?
Whose money was it?
Whose money was it, and how it came to?
I have four questions. Whose money was it? One, that he was taking out of India. That's question number one. Second question which I have here today, who paid him the bribe? Who are all the private corporate houses who paid him the bribe? Thirdly, is it true that there was a minister, an ex-chief minister, and I'm told also a powerful politician from Maharashtra who was involved in this? Is there a truth in that? Fourth, is this to be thrown out? These documents which I have, should they be put in a waste paper basket right now? And finally, if they should not be thrown in a waste paper basket, should the Supreme Court monitor this investigation? Is that the only way of ensuring that there will be justice in this particular case? KTS Tulsi, my last question to you is this. Very often you and I have disagreed on the question of a media trial. In several cases, including the case of Ashok Khemka, you have accused the media of carrying out a trial. In the case of that Haryana politician who drove that young girl to suicide, in the case in which you were involved, you called it a media trial. Would you today say that, you know, the term media trial is an oft-used and sometimes misused expression? This is not a media trial, but for...
No. Today what you have done
is... For the perpetrators of the scam, this
too is a media trial. Today what you have done is... Arnab, this is not media trial because you have been able to locate a criminal and is seeking to bring him to justice. What I want to say is that you also have the right to prosecute them. You don't only have to depend upon the investigating agencies, which may be compromised by vested interests. You are, as a citizen, entitled to investigate and place your material before the court and prosecute them. There is, just like Dr. Subramaniam Swamy has actively prosecuted these people, we need to be powerful enough that we do all that competent investigation. In fact, you can do much better investigation. You have proven it that today than even the official agencies. Why should we depend only on the official agencies? And why should we unnecessarily burden the Supreme Court for the purpose of monitoring? If you can monitor, you can collect evidence, place it before the court, you have the right as a citizen, and then prosecute them. Make sure that the trial is in accordance with law and no witness is compromised and the justice is rendered. You can directly intervene in the dispensing of justice.
But Mr. Tulsi, yes, with some humility, you know, we are running a news channel, not an investigating agency. We'd be happy to share what information we have, but we are not the enforcement directorate or the CBI, Dibang.
You know, I think, Arnab, also, I think we should also mention your reporter Vivek here.
Absolutely, just getting him live right now.
Look at the kind of work he has done.
Exceptional
entire
work.
Entire agency is waiting there. They couldn't do it. And with your support, Vivek has done this. I think these are the new heroes.
Absolutely.
New heroes of the electronic media, the reporters.
Absolutely.
That's where the soul of electronic media is going to be in the coming days. And I think that's a very, very positive change.
I'd like to second that very, very loudly. We are extremely proud here of the work that Vivek Narayan has done.
Yeah.
And I'd also like to say this, Debang, that Vivek Narayan and our camera person, our video journalist there, did take on some degree of personal risk while they were filming
this
man.
Absolutely, because these are dangerous people. They are dangerous people. Yeah. The other thing I think, Arnab, that you should do is to have a campaign to say these corruption cases involving big politicians must be fast-tracked. Okay.